Good afternoon, Rainbow Brigade. It's Paul. I'm happy to hear you have us back all together here in 2017, and it's a great pleasure for me to start this new year out with you. I didn't get to spend last year the full amount of time with you guys, and I really I know I missed out a lot, but I am here now, and we're going to make sure that we have a year where no stone is unturned, and I want to make sure that that is true, because there's going to be a lot of things going on in our country at large. But I don't want us to get all flustered and bothered by that. You know, the people have spoken, so to speak, when they put in Donald Trump in as president. I love the Obamacare that I have, because I'm semi-disabled now, so I don't have the opportunity to get one of these fancy-schmancy corporate policies, and it's expensive to do an individual policy with Blue Cross, which is who I chose, but with the income being reduced for my health reasons, I was able to get a pretty good policy, and I noticed even though it's good, it's costing me about two-thirds as much again as the policy I had last year. And I expect that to continue on. When I had no Obamacare, I was up to about $1,310 a month with United Healthcare, and that wasn't so bad if it was all inclusive, but it was not. And I still had name brand medicines that I needed to take. I have a nervous stomach, and I do get a lot of over acidity. It's knotted up in here, and acid comes up. I have to take Nexium. Maybe you're in my Nexium club too. But at one time, I mean, I was paying over $215 for several years, in addition to the high insurance. So, hopefully, that won't be anything that I'm going to get sticker shock about when we get ready for 2018. But gang, I wanted to say something to you about the specifics of how I met Brad. I think I mentioned that we met through a dating service which was run by a psychologist. Her name was Mrs. Nora Marin, and she wanted to do a gay dating service primarily for HIV pos, and it was a great service. They brought a lot of nice people together that wouldn't have found each other otherwise, because at that time in the 90s, people were thinking, oh gee, I don't want to get involved with somebody because they're not going to want to either touch me, or they're not going to want to get involved with anything that's very intimate. And yes, of course we lost a lot of people in the 80s and 90s before we had our great medicines that we do now. But her dating service for gay HIV positive people went very well, and she thought she'd try a dating service for the rest of us HIV negative guys who still wanted a good relationship, and was treated with it by a psychologist. So she really saw us in a different light, and each individual that she interviewed was a 3 or 4 hour interview session, and so she picked out some good people. I dated two other people before I met Brad, and it was kind of a toss-up between, I like Brad, I liked him a lot. I'm with him now. But there was another guy that was involved in the dating process, my number two man, and he was a charmer, I'll tell you that. And I won't reveal his name, but the fact is, I was smitten, and he made me feel very good about myself, which was good. He was a psychologist too, which was not good, because he used to make his own rules up of what would be appropriate in this dating realm. Well, he led me astray, and he had a boyfriend that was on and off for about 10 years, and he didn't treat him all that great either. So ultimately, I ripped myself away from this fellow and got to know Brad a little bit better. Well, how did I first get to know Brad so well? Well, I think we talked on a Friday night, and a bunch of my friends were going to West Palm Beach to see a horticultural show at Mount's Botanical Gardens in West Palm Beach. And Brad lived in Pompano Beach, and that was about 25, 28 miles from where I am and where we both live now, which is in the southwest Broward, in the Weston Pembroke Southwest Ranches area. Anyway, knocked on his door, never met him before, only had three telephone calls, and well, the man, he liked me. I was overwhelmed. I don't know if I have ever described this to anyone before, but he had a light blue tennis pants short set with a top on, and he was looking at me like a dog who might have been lusting after his master, wanted to hump his master. Brad had a copious amount of pre-cum, little did he realize, that was fanning out all from the front of his light blue shorts. And then I'm thinking pre-cum, he probably put out about 2 or 3 ounces. It's been a while for him, evidently. But I didn't know what to say. I said, gee, Brad, I guess you're happy to see me. What else would I do? I didn't want to minimize it with humor too much, but the fact is, I had to keep that light. So I said, how about I walk around your house and, you know, look at the knickknacks, go outside on the patio, pet your cat, and you you get yourself another outfit on. Because it really was. I was flattered, and I think that one situation that occurred, and I don't know how many people that's happened to you, or you've spilled your cum for other guys that you met the first time, but it right away took us out of a reality of mundane interaction for a date, and I mean we were swept into intimacy just by that occurring. And I'm not saying that I had any intimate relations with Brad for either that day or the next couple of days. I didn't see any reason to. I had certainly a great idea about what was on his mind, so yeah, I didn't. I guess this guy liked me, as I was saying to myself, and yeah, he did. So, if a guy does meet you at the door someday and his pants within 2 or 3 minutes are wet and sticky, that's, you'll know the guy is the right guy for you, most likely. Well, we went from there. I mean, I think because that did occur, it did bring us into a situation where I know this guy was special, and he drew me out, and he was such a good guy then. I mean, he was really a really sweet man, and that he still is. This was a man who needed somebody special in his life, and I think that the compatibility quotient was phenomenal. So that's how Brad Scobie and Paul Naraki got together, you know, with the hands of a higher power, meaning his incredibly nice, uncut 10 inches of manhood. He produces a lot of love for his person that he loves, and I never doubted that for a minute. And that was our story. About see a month after we met, I said to him, would you like to go to Puerto Rico with me? At that time, there was Eastern Airlines was having special deals called the Weekenders Club, and if seats weren't filled on a given weekend, wherever those seats were available, they would email you the day before. You could pick from about 4 or 5 destinations, and I'd like to go to Puerto Rico. It's nice. It's just got a good atmosphere, friendly people, food's good, nice beaches, nice rainforest. So I asked him, would he like to go? We had never been anywhere together, and I think we had only in intimate maybe 4 or 5 times, maybe 5 or 6 times. It wasn't much more than that. But we had a great opportunity to get intimate in San Juan, because after we got there, we started to put on the news, and we were talking about Hurricane Bertha, and it looked like it was going to skirt the island, and we would be inundated within, I guess, 48 hours. Still a little oblivious to it. We had a nice rental car. We drove up to the El Yunque rainforest. On the way back, we took another road home, and I think it was Puerto Rico Highway number 10. It was a wonderful state park up in the highlands that we stopped in. Just beautiful. Puerto Rico is great too when you go on one of the state roads. There's these hole-in-the-wall restaurants or bars that are just at the curve of a hillside on the highway, and you just pull off, and you can do your shopping and tasting of some really nice liqueurs and liquor that we don't usually get in the States. So I was a little toasty. I think I was introduced to 40 tres. I guess it's a pretty well-known liqueur. I don't know what the specific flavor that it does impart, but it's a kind of a caramelly sweet, but very potent blend. So we had that with some heavy cream put in it, and it's good. It was really good. So that was that we had that. We drove around, winding around the island, drove down this Highway 10 where it goes back into the lowlands, and we had clicked onto a St. Croix Virgin Islands radio station, and they were talking about a hurricane coming. So we said, "Whoa, this is going to be interesting." Now, having realized that Puerto Rico has gone through hurricane after hurricane without undue permanent damage, we figured, it'll be fine, a little wind, and we'll just enjoy the hurricane party. Well, it was a little bit more than that. The gay guest house we were staying had jalousie windows, which meant those little panes that the sand just came rushing through for the whole day of Saturday. We were under the covers with the little kitten that they had in this guest house, and everybody was pretty freaked out, but here we go again with these once-in-a-lifetime experiences that he and I just sort of fell in with fate. And after the storm was over, nothing was seriously damaged. There was usual coconuts down and a couple of trees down, but not so bad. It hit basically 50 miles just to the west of San Juan, so we were barely in the eye, maybe a little off the eye, but it was enough. But oh God, we had 3 or 4 inches of sand on the sheets, on the pillows, and luckily we were under the sheets with our cat, and I think we were holding each other's cocks, which was, that's what you do when you're in a hurricane with somebody that you love. What could be safer than holding somebody's cocks and jerking him off? It was pretty darn special. And that was our furthest back history thing that was our pivotal turning point. There were to be many others, and I'll elaborate about those later on, but I wanted you to know that we were sealed in cum, basically, and it was a wonderful place to be. And I love him still. I love him more than I did the day before, and I'm sure I'm going to love him more in the upcoming days. He's a good man, and I'm a lucky man. I just wanted to say, what the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to cross. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Bum, 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 ba-dum. Bum, bum, ba-dum. That's the only thing that we really never get too much of. Love you guys. This is so much fun going to be with you this year. Let's just really get closer. and let's really love each other. Tell me all your secrets, I'll tell you mine. I'll show you yours if you show me mine. I love you guys. Take care. Paul signing out. Till next time, have a really good month of January, really good 2017. I'll be with you. Bye-bye.